Water laps the bridge over South Willow Creek on the outskirts of Willows in Glynn County. Heavy equipment fishes out debris, one bucket after another, in an ongoing effort to prevent a log jam and keep the bridge over the water instead of under it. Flood levels like this haven't been seen in nearly two decades.
It looks like it did back in 96, 98, and I don't think I've seen that area that high since then.
Cal OES's regional administrator, Eric Lamoureux, meets with a Glynn County Sheriff's deputy. There's no better intel than seeing it with your own eyes. At this point during the storm, Glynn County is ready to activate its emergency operations center. Just down the road, a stretch of Highway 99 is closed. The lone big rig makes the right decision to stay put. Emergency responders like Lieutenant Sean Arlen are keeping track of the storm and its effects on Glynn County.
And we're going to monitor the situation constantly and hourly, and we'll be in contact with our partners.
One partner is Cal OES. Here at the Regional Emergency Operations Center, or REOC, representatives from Cal OES, the Red Cross, and other agencies conduct conference calls to keep everyone informed and up to date.
We've pre-deployed. We're in many areas where local EOCs are not yet activated.
Those regional centers are coordinating and working with local authority, and those three region centers are funneling up information to the state operations center here, where we are keeping a statewide snapshot of what's happening.
Here at the State Operations Center in Sacramento, teams commingle incoming information and data to put that statewide picture together. That snapshot is then conveyed to the public by way of interviews with the media. At the same time, the effects of the storm continue to evolve. It's slow going on southbound I-5, traffic backed up for miles due to flooded highway lanes north of Willows. This mobile home park in Red Bluff was inundated with floodwaters, while right across the street, the Tehama County Sheriff's Office defended itself with sandbags. Inside, Tehama County EOC held a briefing, mutual aid agencies represented. Then it's back on the road for Cal OES to meet with Tehama County residents, some of whom have lived here a long time.
55 years, my whole life.
Rancher Kevin Bohr says this is typical during years with normal rainfall. He's seen worse.
83, 96, I can't remember them all, but 83 was the worst. It surprises me that everybody gets all excited, and I'm sure there's some people that have damage, and don't get me wrong, I feel for those people, but this is how it is, how it has been in the past, and that's why we have flood zones.
And folks in these parts know how to build in and around those flood zones. Build it high, and it'll stay dry. A prime example of hazard mitigation.
A lot of water. I don't discount that at all, but we've had this before. Well, hopefully we'll have it again. It's a lot better than not having any water.